Let me be honest, portfolios just don't work anymore. If you're a designer like me who wants to find clients, let me tell you there's a better way. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how. Hey friends, my name is Raphael, I'm a Webflow expert and I started my business now 3 years ago. In the beginning, it was basically impossible to find any new clients. I would constantly create new versions of my portfolio, but it just didn't do anything. I realized I was kind of stuck in the cycle of creating and updating my portfolio, hoping for something to happen, which was not only frustrating, but also really time consuming. That's when I realized I had to shift my strategy and try something completely different. So today I'm going to show you why you don't really need a traditional design portfolio and what you should be doing instead. The problem with traditional portfolios is they focus too much on showcasing the visual work. You have to understand that clients don't just want to see pretty things, they want to know if you can basically solve their problems. Also, portfolios are really static. They don't really engage your potential clients and they don't lead them on a specific path. You see, most of the time your clients won't be design experts, so they won't notice the tiny details and they probably won't understand your work unless you explain it to them. Let me be honest, I've made all of these mistakes I'm sharing today with you myself. I know it's tough and I've been there, so don't worry. Now, what's the solution to this portfolio problem? Instead of relying on a totally static portfolio, you have way higher chances of success if you use a dynamic, well-crafted sales page that can really convert your visitors into clients. So what is a sales page? A sales page basically takes your visitors on a path. It can tell a story, address the pain point of your potential clients, and it pushes them towards action. Now, before we get too technical here, let me show you how I've built my sales page that drastically helped me find new clients and convert visitors. And there's basically a simple framework that you can use that has 5 components that almost every successful sales page out there is using. So let's start with the first one, the hook. First thing your visitors will see on your website is your headline. This is your hook and it really needs to work. You will not believe how much a headline can make or break a sales page. One thing to remember here, your headline itself will not convert visitors on its own, but rather hook the visitor into reading more and thereby converting at a later stage. So instead of a generic, "Hi, I'm Raphael, I'm a designer," use something that talks directly to your client. That is the headline that I'm using, Webflow websites that take your business to the next level. It not only sells my expertise as a Webflow expert, it also has this component of transforming the business of a potential client, and I found that to be working quite good. So here are 3 steps to write a great headline for your own sales page. Number 1, be clear and direct. Don't use any jargon, your client won't understand it anyway. And make sure your value offer is immediately obvious. Second one is sell the benefit, not the feature. Talk about what your client will gain and not just what you are doing. And step number 3 is to create some kind of curiosity. Make the visitor really want to read more and to know what you're all about and what you're offering them. The goal of the headline is not to convert visitors on its own, but rather to make them want to read more. So the next point on your sales page is to really highlight the problem that your client is currently facing. Basically, you need to show potential clients that you understand what their problem is. This helps you build trust and makes them feel understood. So what I've been using to do this on my sales page is basically something like normal compromises when creating a website. Because the idea is that a lot of clients are facing the problems that they have, like a vision, but they don't know how to implement it and they face a lot of problems with developers and it's very complicated. And so you basically want to do 2 things in one. You want to show, hey, this is your problem, I get it, you've been struggling with this. And on the other hand, you want to say, if you have this problem, I'm offering you the best solution there is. And that's really powerful in my opinion. So after you've identified their problem, it's time to present your solution. This section should really outline how your services can make their problems go away and help them achieve success. So what I've done here on my sales page is I present these 3 services and I show my services in a way that really makes it obvious for the client that this will solve the problem. And what I'm doing here is I don't just show my services, but I also provide a little bit of a description, which I think makes it a lot more attractive for potential clients. And what I also have here is a little what I call us versus them section. And what makes my offering stand out against traditional agencies. So highly recommend that you also have this us versus them section. So the important thing here is to break down your approach to really make the client feel that you are the right choice and the right one to solve the problems. Okay, the next part about our sales page is proof, and more specifically, social proof. Now I know what some of you guys might thinking. This is a little bit salesy. This is like what marketing people do. The thing is, they do it because it works and it builds credibility and trust. Potential clients will go on your website and they will see that you have already completed some other projects and they will trust you a lot more. Let's say, for example, you go on Amazon and you look for the perfect coffee machine and you basically see two that you like and one like has not a lot of reviews, maybe just one or two, and the other one has over 1,000 reviews, which were overwhelmingly positive. And so I'm asking you the really stupid obvious question, which one would you go for? So testimonials are really, really powerful. So what I'm doing on my sales page for proof is a couple things. The first one is presenting like a logos with clients and projects I've worked on. Second one is like showing a portfolio from a happy client, which is always a great idea because it also shows like a little bit of social proof and that you've actually worked on something and not just you say that you can do it. And so it may sound a bit cringy, but the purpose is to show that you can actually walk the walk and not only talk the talk. And so the last element on a sales page is the actual offer. So finally, your sales page needs a strong call to action or CTA. So this is the point where you tell your visitors exactly what's the next step they need to do, whether it's booking a consultation, downloading a free guide, or whatever makes sense for your specific website. For this, you should really use action-oriented language, like get started, register now, or book a call. It needs to be simple and tell the visitor exactly what will happen once the button is clicked. So what I'm doing on my sales pitch is I'm offering a free website audit, and basically the call to action is register now for your free website audit. So it not only highlights the benefit of it being free, it's only very action oriented. And so these are basically the five components that your sales page needs to have. And now one little bonus tip for your sales page is to really use A/B testing. So you might be wondering which headline works the best, which doesn't. And so this is where A and B testing comes in. So basically how A and B testing works is you split your traffic into two routes, show them two exact websites, but you change just one tiny thing, for example, the headline. And through the analytics, you will later find out which one performs better. And so you can gradually increase the effectiveness of your sales page step by step, which is just so powerful. And one little thing I forgot to mention is don't overcomplicate it in the beginning. Just get out your first version of your sales page, test it and improve it over time. It's just impossible right from the beginning to create the perfect sales page. So just try and iterate and it will be better over time. So that's basically it. If you found this video valuable, I would love for you to consider subscribing. We're on the road to 2,000 subscribers, which is really a lot. And I'm really happy to be on this journey with you and help you launch your business. If you're now feeling a little bit stuck and not knowing what to do next, no problem. I've created a video where I talk a little bit how to find your next web design client. So check that out and I'll see you in the next video.